Hi, my name is Tai-Danae Bradley, and today I am joined with Nadia Harhen and Adam Lewis from the Simulation and Optimization team at Sandbox. Nadia, Adam, thanks for being here today.
Thank you so much. Happy to be here.
Happy to be here.
Great. So let me just ask a very basic question just to start. What is simulation and optimization?
Yeah, so simulation and optimization are a class of two different kinds of problems that one can solve mostly using computers. Simulation refers, in the broadest sense, to taking a computer and causing it to behave like some other system, like a financial market or a pendulum or, say, a drug molecule, so that you can study that system inside the computer, in silico, as we say, without necessarily having to manipulate it with the lab experiment. Optimization is a larger set of problems. You can think of it as a kind of math, so a mathematical discipline concerned with finding solutions to problems that are optimal, that is, that balance parameters in a beneficial way. You can also think of it as a set of computer algorithms that deal with those sorts of problems. A little more high level, you can think of it as a way of using computers to tell us what we should do. So if you think of simulation as a way of telling what's going to happen, like predicting the world, optimization is a way of making actionable information out of those predictions.
So that's a great overview, but now let me just ask, and you kind of touched on this, but maybe we can go a little deeper. What kind of problems does that solve?
Yeah, so at the moment we're focused on drug discovery, and that is simply because drug discovery, as we see it, is quite broken. It takes over a decade to develop a brand new drug. It costs billions of dollars, and the failure rate is just extraordinarily high. Most drugs fail at the clinical stages, which are very, very expensive. And so we want to disrupt that entire process.
Great. So can you share more about your team and what you're doing?
Absolutely. We've built a really great team of computational chemists, medicinal chemists, physicists, our scientific advisory board, and they all work very, very closely together to tackle these incredibly challenging topics. And clients, they come to us with some of their hardest problems, and that's what we're able to tackle. They have exhausted all of the tools on the market, and then, you know, they basically come to SandboxAQ, and they need us to help them take their problems to the next step. One of the things that we also think through is our quantum approach. And we really want to develop the technologies that enable us to be ready for the eventual quantum computers that will be available in addition.
Great.
Just if I can jump in quick. Yeah. As a physicist, it's really unusual to see a team which, first of all, has so much physics expertise and is paired with a team both on the business side and also of practical medicinal chemists that are really able to immediately execute on these difficult problems. And this collaboration has been very special to work as part of, and I think it is really something quite unique.
So within that goal, are there any kinds of particular problems or techniques that you're specifically focused on?
Yeah, so within the goal of drug discovery, you can think of it, I mean, we can think about problems within drug discovery we're working on solving, and we can think about scientific problems that we're looking on solving in a more technical way. I think the things on the higher level that we're thinking about are improving the speed that it takes to go from a certain drug hypothesis, a therapeutic hypothesis. So let me back up a little bit. So at the beginning of the drug discovery process, someone, maybe an academic, it could sometimes be an internal researcher, will have some kind of idea about what causes a certain disease. That's a therapeutic hypothesis. And it'll be developed in such a way that the company hopes to develop a therapy that would action upon the disease. So what we'd like is to improve the process of getting good therapeutic hypotheses and then on actioning upon them more quickly. So using simulation, we can speed up, and optimization, we can speed up the process of going from hypothesis to drug. That's problem one that we kind of think about, is like making this process faster and more efficient. Problem two is about expanding the range of therapeutic hypotheses which are actionable. And that means expanding the cut type of what are called drug targets that it's possible to simulate and therefore to act upon in a non-simulation way.
That's fascinating. So,
yeah, and we have an additional hypothesis, which is that the drug companies out there have sort of picked all of the low-hanging fruit. And so the diseases that are really left to drug, those are the ones that are really, really tough. so cancers, neurodegenerative diseases, and they're otherwise known as undruggable targets. Now, that doesn't mean that they're actually undruggable. Mm-hmm. It's just that no one has been able to do them yet because it is just extraordinarily difficult. It takes new tools, it takes new techniques, it takes new expertise, and that's the type of thing that we focus on here at Sandbox AQ.
So speaking of AQ, where the A stands for artificial intelligence and the Q stands for quantum, how is your work related to AQ?
Yeah, so our North Star is in combining AI and quantum into methods that don't require data, but which benefit from data. So AI methods to us, we're referring mostly to machine learning, as methods that take data and use them to make inferences for problems where you don't necessarily have a clear problem statement. So an example of this is toxicity prediction. There's just so many different things going on in the human body. Maybe one day we'll have a full characterization of them. I think that would be very exciting, and I know there are people working towards that. But today, we don't have that characterization, but we do have a lot of data about what sorts of interventions lead to toxic effects. And so we can right now make effective predictions of toxicity. That's just an example. Q for us refers to physics-based methods in general, and specifically to methods that derive their effect from quantum physics. And these, we're really seeing a sharp increase in the advantage and power of these methods. And they play an interesting adjacent role to AI because they do not require data. Instead, they require a clear problem statement. So you have to be able to describe the system you're trying to model quite quickly. And this comes up a lot in the drug design space when you're talking about molecules, proteins, things on this scale interacting with each other, because you usually do know the physics. And you can make predictions about how that works using these quantum methods. And you can make exponentially better predictions about how they work with the new quantum methods. Finally, what we're really excited about is methods that combine the A and the Q together to get methods that do benefit from a problem statement, but might not require it to be completely 100% clear and correct, and which also benefit from some data, but don't require a massive store, which often is not available in the drug discovery space because there just, honestly, aren't that many known molecules with tagged information about them compared to, say, how many sentences on the internet they are. So data is available. There's enough to do very interesting things, but it's often very useful to supplement it with knowledge of the physics, which is also available. And that's a big difference between, say, natural language again. So by combining these together, we are making impact on what we can do, drug and drug discovery, materials, and financial markets, and beyond.
And this is very critical to uncovering new types of drugs and materials. Mm-hmm. It's really key that we just don't need the underlying data necessarily. It's great if we have it, as Adam said, but if we don't, we're still able to do and new drug discovery.
So if I could just ask Nadia, how does what your team does, how is that different from what's currently out there?
Yeah, so basically, because we focus on undruggable targets, there's not a lot of companies that do this. And so we really, you know, exhaust the tools that are available, and we take a really bespoke approach to solving the problems at hand. And so we partner very closely with the teams that we work with, whether it's neurodegenerative diseases or in the cancer space. We partner very, very closely, use the experts, and work in a very iterative way in order to solve these problems, because the tools out there are, frankly, you can think about them as blunt tools, mm-hmm. right? So they don't work for the specificity that we're looking for.
Wow. So thinking in the future now, what can we expect to see from your team going forward?
Yeah, that's a great question. So at the moment, we're focused, as you know, on drug discovery. We're trying to take years, as Adam said, off the lifespan of molecules to medicine. And what that will do is ultimately bring revenue back in the hands of the company if they're able to, you know, every year equals $1 billion for a blockbuster. So that's in the here and now. But in the future, we're hoping to expand out to materials discovery and portfolio optimization, risk optimization, logistics, things like that, that have the same underlying tool sets that we are able to use in these different industries as it relates to optimization, and similarly for the drug discovery class of problems.
Amazing. You guys are doing some really fascinating work. I really appreciate you taking the time to sit here today with me. So thank you so much.
Thank you.